back in Cleveland as we get set for the Browns and the Saints on a 60-degree afternoon. Downstairs to Tony Siragusa. Goose.
Thanks, Kenny. You know, I don't get excited very often, but today you got two guys, Rob Ryan and Mike Pettine. I got to speak with both of them. It's a mirror image. Both of these defenses, these guys know each other very good. And with those two, it's all about the sky. So early in this game, keep an eye on both of these defenses. They're not going to show what they're going to do all game.
Now the Browns, Goose, won the toss, elected to defer, so it will be the Cleveland defense on the field first as Mike Pettine elects to give the ball to the Saints offense led onto the field by Drew Brees.
Yeah, we'll have to see how that pans out. You know, if I had questions about my defense, you know, let's go find out how the Saints defense are going to play this week. So surprise, the Browns deferred and bring Drew Brees and this high-powered offense out of the field.
If you want to give your defense some confidence, then you're going out first no matter what. I mean, that's a great, big decision, big decision. Let's see how it works out for them.
First and 10 from the 20-yard line for the Saints, who lost in overtime in Atlanta last Sunday. Out of the backfield, it's Pierre Thomas. Carlos Dansby right there to make the tackle.
And when you go back to last week against Atlanta, I love Zach Streif's comments. Like, listen, everybody's been waiting to see who we are, and we come out and lose the first game. That doesn't mean anything. That's not how we're going to be judged all season long. This group, this offensive group, played very well last week. A couple more plays, they win that Atlanta game. They understand that, but there's no panic on the offensive side of the ball.
A quick pace with this New Orleans offense right off the bat.
Same as always.
Yep. Saints into the backfield. Brees had trouble with the snap, and now he fires. It'll be third down and 10.
Little mishandle on the snap right here, but, you know, Drew Brees does the right thing. There's no panic, a little high, a little wobbly. Get it, secure it, get it out of there. Don't take the sack, don't make the bad play.
He knows he's in the pocket right here, does a good job of throwing in the middle of the field where he knows he won't get a penalty also.
Third down and 10. Saints must get to the 30, and they will not. Brandon Cooks, the rookie out of Oregon State, gain of just one. Saints go three and out. We'll punt it away.
Yeah, and it ends up being a good decision to defer. They gain the momentum. Like Tony said, that defense now playing with confidence after the first series. And beyond that, really, in the first half last week against Pittsburgh, where the Browns struggled, we're on those screen plays. Those were where a lot of the big chunks came. They defended two of them very well in that opening series.
Yeah, the screen play is all about hustle. You got to run to the ball.
Thomas Morstead punting from his own 10-yard line. Fair catch called for at the 35 by Travis Benjamin. 54-yard punt. Good field position for Brian Hoyer and the Browns offense.
Yeah, we all know about the battle that went on in the offseason between Brian Hoyer and Johnny Manziel. Local boy does good. It's a great story. He played really well in the second half. But when you watch that film, there were just some breakdowns in the first half. They actually moved the ball up and down the field, but just couldn't finish drives.
There's a guy to look at right there, Darrell Terrence West. Running back, really impressive rookie.
Gained 100 yards, Goose, in his NFL debut last week. Starting for the injured Ben Tate. And this is West out of Towson. Takes it out to the 39-yard line. A gain of 4 on first down, wrapped up by Paris Harrelson.
And when you turn on the film, one of the things that jumps out at you is this front five right here, a very good offensive line. If Terrence West and Isaiah Crowell are going to have good afternoons, it all hinges on those guys. They're going to have to do that again today because Kyle Shanahan's offense is based off of play action. If that running game becomes something that concerns the Saints, it's a huge advantage to the Browns.
Without Van Tate, and their star tight end Jordan Cameron today as well. Catch is made for a first down by Andrew Hawkins. Patrick Robinson brought him down after a gain of 10. So this the Saints defense out onto the field. They allowed 568 yards against the Falcons last week.
Yeah, a number of reasons felt like they didn't get pressure on the quarterback. They didn't tackle well, so a lot of things they have to shore up this afternoon.
From the 49-yard line on first down, this is West. West, gain of just one to midfield, brought down by Keenan Lewis, 2nd and 9 upcoming.
A big talk in Cleveland during the course of the week was this up-tempo style that they're starting the game with. That second half, they were in hurry-up mode. They can't do it all the time, but Kyle Shanahan wants to add it at different points during the course of the afternoon.
The toss to West on 2nd down to the Saints 47. Junior Gallette made the tackle, so it will be 3rd down and 6 for the Browns on their opening possession. Isaiah Crowell in for Terrence West. Crowell, 2 touchdowns in his NFL debut. Rookie out of Alabama State. 3rd down and 6. Three wide receivers for the Browns. Hoyer to the outside, and this time unable to connect with Hawkins, so Cleveland will punt.
Little overthrown on the outside, so Rob Ryan's group comes out. Has a positive first series.
Jarris Bird back deep for the Saints. Spencer Lanning will punt it away for the Browns. Antonio Brown's cleat no longer planted in Lanning's face mask. Fair catch by Bird. So Drew Brees and the Saints offense back out. Browns defense forced a 3 and out earlier.
To by Southwest Airlines. Without a heart, it's just a machine.
Sean Payton's Saints will start from their 8-yard line. Payton returning to Cleveland, where he coached his first NFL game back in 2006 as a head coach. Saints went 3 and out on their opening drive. Brees from the goal line. Down he goes. Marked down at the 1.
Woof. Now Paul Kruger has really upped his game this season, Goose. He's going to come from the outside right here at the bottom of the screen. Let's watch where Drew Brees sets up. We see that ball is outside. It's outside of the end zone when he makes contact, so that's why it's not a safety. He was driven back into the end zone.
As long as the tip of the football is outside the end zone, no safety. Paul Kruger initially credited with 2 sacks last week, 1 taken away during the week, so that's his 2nd of the season. Play clock at 1, and Brees is forced to use a timeout.
Now, Mike Pettine, you see him trying to calm everybody down right there, keep their emotions in check. They are playing really well right now. They have, Tony, you mentioned the disguise, and what you see at the snap is not necessarily what is going to be played post-snap. His defense is doing a really nice job right now because that was that long wholesale play action where you've got 2 receivers down the field, and the Browns just had it absolutely smothered. There was nowhere for Drew Brees to go, which allowed Paul Kruger to get in and get that sack.
Yeah, that's the extra time that you get when you do those kinds of things. And I'll tell you what, I'm really impressed by this Cleveland's defense, not just the way that they're pass rushing, but running to the ball and tackling well, something they didn't do last week at all, especially early in the game last week.
2nd down and 17. Off the fake to Ingram. Brees with time, and the catch is made, and then a big hit on Ingram is made by the former Cardinal and Dolphin, Carlos Dansby.
That is well done by Carlos Dansby. He dropped back, get some depth, force Drew Brees to check it down, and then watch the tackle. No issues with that tackle right there for
right
Carlos Dansby.
That's how I used to tackle there, Dal.
Yeah.
I wish.
Dansby, along with Dante Whitner, a couple of the veterans brought in by the Browns during the offseason, guys that have played in Super Bowls and have brought the veteran experience and leadership. 3rd down and 12. Play clock again at 1. Saints get the snap off. Brees hit as he throws, and for the 2nd consecutive series, the Saints go 3 and out.
And this is going to be difficult with their position to punt the ball, 2 backed up. They're going to have maximum distance all the way in the back of that end zone. But again, the Browns are getting pressure onto Drew Brees with just four. You've got a lot of guys at the line of scrimmage creating that disguise, but look, there's just four guys coming in, and they are continually getting pressure with just those four.
Now the punter, Darryl Morstead, limped off the field following his first punt, set up towards the back of the end zone. Travis Benjamin back deep for the Browns. Taking out the 47, Benjamin eludes the first tackler. And now he is down after a short return. 47-yard punt. Terrific job by the Browns defense. Paul Kruger coming through with the sack of Drew Brees.
To my Bud Light, who reminds fans to stay in the game and drink responsibly.
No score in Cleveland. Being inactive today for the Browns. Three starters, Tate Cameron and linebacker Marcavius Mingo. And for the Saints, the Canton, Ohio native out of Walsh University in Canton, Joseph Morgan, not active today. First and 10 from the 49-yard line. The toss to Terrence West, turns the corner into Saints territory. Knocked out of bounds on the 47-yard line by Curtis Lofton after a gain of four.
One of the reasons I like this offensive line is their athleticism. And that's what happens when you get big bodies moving. You have a guy that can rush for 100 yards as a rookie in his first chance out there in the NFL. So whether it's their zone blocking scheme where they're on their feet continuing to push the line of scrimmage, or there where you're pulling and wrapping around, a very athletic group up front.
Two tight end set for the Browns. Off the fake to West. Boyer with time. He swings it out. It's West. And Terrence West has a first down. West for the Saints, 36. Gain of 11, time for a game break to Los Angeles. Joel Klatt, Joel.
All right, Kenny, we go to Minnesota. Of course, the former MVP Adrian Peterson out, inactive today, but his replacement, Matt Asiata, out of the backfield, 25-yard TD score, Vikings up 7-0. Back to Cleveland, Kenny, Moose, and Goose.
All right, thanks, Joel. First and 10 from the 36-yard line. Split wide to the left, empty backfield. Boyer moving to his right, under pressure, fires downfield, looking for the tight end Jim Drake. Kaden Lewis on the coverage.
Yeah, really lucky right there in that situation. Brian Hoyer's got to understand that that play wasn't open enough to float one down into the right side of the field. Very lucky that was not intercepted by the New Orleans Saints. You know, as you're playing back and forth, creating field position, you're in a good spot right now. You have the potential for points right here, so don't have a turnover to take away the opportunity for your team to convert.
Second and 10, Crowell in the backfield. Behind the fullback, Ray Agnew. This is Crowell. Down to the Saints, 33. Hakeem Hicks brought him down.
Isaiah Crowell is really a perfect fit for what they're doing in the running game here in Cleveland. You talk about that zone blocking scheme. It's getting on a path, staying on that path, and then it's one cut and gone. And Isaiah Crowell does it very well naturally.
It slows you down also because on the play action, you get that same blocking up front. So you got to determine whether it's a pass or a run. It really keeps the defensive lineman off balance.
Third down at 7. Boyer. There's a flag. Two flags. Patrick Robinson on the coverage. Taylor Gabriel, the rookie out of Abilene Christian, the intended receiver.
One-on-one coverage on the outside. If you're going to blitz, that's what's going to happen.
Defense, number 21. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. Automatic first down.
Easy call for the officials right there. He's stride for stride. He's looking back for the ball, but he initiates too much contact with Taylor Gabriel.
Browns gain 19 yards on the penalty. New set of downs for the Saints, 14. Boyer throws, and the pass is short. Intended for the fullback, Agnew. Pressure from Junior Gillette on Brian Hoyer, who's making his sixth start in the National Football League, his fifth as a Brown. He was 3-0 last season before suffering the ACL injury.
Had a great second half last week against Pittsburgh, but you go back to earlier in his career, he spent some time up in New England, so you're getting to learn from Tom Brady, who many will consider to be, if not the best in the game when it's all said and done, one of the top three quarterbacks in NFL history.
Hoyer hands it off to West, and it was three full seasons in New England for Brian Hoyer, and he said, Tom didn't really need much coaching, so I got to spend a lot of time with Bill O'Brien, who was on the Patriots staff at the time, and I was able to do so much extra work because you really don't have to coach Tom Brady.
Yeah, and you know, one of the big things I think is the fact that he talked about how much Tom emphasized fundamentals, and one of the things that Johnny Manziel right there is going to have to learn as he makes his path into the NFL. It's about footwork. It's about being in the pocket. There's certain things, and if you're Brian Hoyer and all of a sudden a guy like Tom Brady is continually harping on fundamentals, that's going to be your focus as well.
Hoyer on third and 12. Over to his right. Now he throws, and the catch is made by West. Looks to be just shy of the marker. Kenny Vaccaro made the tackle.
Well, one of the things that I like about Terrence West and Isaiah Crowell at the start of this game is we know what they can do as runners. We saw that last week. It's a natural thing. But I've seen Isaiah Crowell in blitz pickup give Brian Hoyer the time. And here's Terrence West out ad-libbing a play and making a catch down the field.
Browns leaving the offense on the field on fourth down. This is West, and he picks up the first.
Quick decision, quick cadence at the line of scrimmage. What that shows you right there, the Browns confident, they're committed. They're going to play this. Mike Pettine is going to play this game aggressively. You see him defer at the beginning of the game. All right, yeah. Go ahead, put Drew Brees in that high-powered offense out there. We'll come out and see what we can do defensively. And now an opportunity on fourth down inside the five. We're going for it. And not only going for it, we're going for it, and we're committed to that.
Three wide receivers set. First and goal from the three. Off the fake to West. Fire. End zone. Touchdown. Miles Austin.
To think about, you get man-to-man out the outside, Patrick Robinson versus Miles Austin, beats him on the release right there, push him up, hard to the inside, and that's a nice drive by the Cleveland Browns. They threw a lot of different things at that Saints defense during the course of that drive.
Billy Cundiff for the extra point. So Miles Austin, the longtime Dallas Cowboy, first touchdown as a member of the Cleveland Browns.
Today's Game on Fox is sponsored by Pizza Hut's Bacon and Cheese Stuffed Crust. By the new Samsung Galaxy S5, the next big thing is here. And by Chevrolet, find new roads.
Rock and Roll Hall of Fame here in Cleveland. Browns rolling here in the first quarter. Their defense has been terrific. A 9-play, 51-yard drive. They convert on fourth and one. And then Miles Austin with the touchdown. You may have noticed Austin threw the ball to the stands. That is not a penalty, but he will be fined for that.
Be no consequences this afternoon. During the course of the week, though.
Taken out of the end zone by Cadet. Tackled at the 12. Kaywan Williams, terrific play on special teams. The 8-time Pro Bowler Drew Brees leads the Saints offense back onto the field. September 10th, 2006, Sean Payton's first game as Saints head coach. First game with the Saints for Drew Brees. First NFL game for Marcus Colston. His first career touchdown. And then Josh Bullocks with the interception of Brown starter Charlie Fry. Saints win it 19-14.
They're coming up here just hoping to win a game and play well. And that was the first of many wins for Drew Brees and Sean Payton together. A very dynamic head coach quarterback combo.
This is Mark Ingram. Former Heisman Trophy winner knocked out of bounds by Joe Hayden. The Saints still looking for their first down of the game.
and probably still going through that process with only six plays run of finding out where their matchup lies. Obviously, on the first six plays, they haven't found it yet against this Browns defense. But that's what they do, you know. They'll go through and try and find out where we're going to get that favorable matchup. And a lot of it hinges around Jimmy Graham all the way up here on the top.
Second down and four. Breeze hits Ingram out of the backfield. And Mark Ingram out to the 21-yard line, about a half yard shy of a first.
And one of the things about Jimmy Graham at that tight end position for the Saints is he's going to be all over the formation. He's going to be in a traditional tight end spot with his hand down. He'll be an inside slot guy to either side. He'll be the extended guy out on the formation like he was on that last play. And that's going to be the key for the Browns. Dante Werner told us we're always counting him as a wide receiver. So if there's two wide receivers out there with Jimmy Graham, that's three wides to us.
On third down and one, the inside handoff to the fullback, Austin Johnson. And the Saints have their first down of the game, and it's the fullback.
When all else fails, Kenny, go to the fullback.
That's true. That's very true.
Austin Johnson, who spent last year on the Saints practice squad. Eric Loring, number one on the depth chart, out once again today. So Johnson picks up the first. From the 23 on first down, it's Pierre Thomas. And now we send it to Los Angeles once again for an update. Joel Klatt. Joel.
Kenny, we take you to Washington. A lot going on here. RG3 rolling to his right, and he's going to go down awkwardly on a completion, but down on the sidelines. Enter Kirk Cousins. Two plays later, Darryl Young, wide open on the sideline. That's a 20-yard touchdown. Washington takes a 7-0 lead. Griffin carted to the locker room in an air cast, guys.
Wow, thanks, Joel. Darryl's making the fullbacks. Darryl Young. Let's get starting fullback with the touchdown. Pass broken up by Joe Hayden, intended for Brandon Cooks.
Yeah, and I was actually very impressed with Drew Brees' comments about Brandon Cooks. It's very rare that you have a young guy step into the league and really impress somebody like Drew Brees as much as Brandon Cooks has. And a lot of it is not what he does physically and what he brings to the table as an athlete, but his passion for the game and his intelligence and his desire to do the right thing time and time again. That's what Drew Brees is looking for, because now he can trust him in the passing game.
Yeah, I like when he says you never see this kid go and make the same mistake twice. Just gets better and better every day.
Brees forced to use another timeout with the play clock winding down. So the Saints use their second timeout in the first quarter.
And that's surprising, because they do play this up-tempo style. You would think that they would have plenty of time at the line of scrimmage to get everything sorted out.
Well, we talked about this defense and how they go and disguise things.
Well, NFL Week 2 continues later today on CBS and for some of you on Fox. Then tonight with Sunday Night Football on NBC. Tune in tomorrow, Monday Night Football on ESPN. Browns have held Jimmy Graham without a catch so far today. Third down at 6. Movement prior to the snap. It's a false start.
False start. Offense. Number 72. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
That's the second-year left tackle, Teron Armstead.
Drew Brees has got to get his group settled down a little bit right now. Yeah. You're on the road, but you're a veteran group. You're more mature than this. You should be able to handle the noise, the distractions, and Sean Payton can't be happy with how his offense has performed here early in this game with things that are within their control.
Third down at 11. Brees with time, and the pass gets batted down at the line. Jabal Sheard got a piece of it. Saints will punt it away.
You're trying to get to the quarterback. You know that the time has elapsed and the ball's about to get out. They slide into the middle. That's just great pressure continuing to work to the quarterback by Jabal Sheard. get those hands up into the throwing lanes, reach out into the face of the quarterback.
Yeah, Drew Brees, I'll tell you what, he's holding on to the ball a long time in that pocket.
Credit the coverage of the Browns, Tony. They're doing a heck of a job.
Great job with these guys.
Well, the Saints guys with only one first down, their first three possessions. Fair catch called for by Benjamin. So once again, Cleveland with terrific field position. They will start from their 42-yard line. Rough start for the Saints offense. Drew Brees along with backup Luke McCown, a former Brown, checking out the photos from the last drive on the new NFL tablet.
And I tell you, the decision to defer by Mike Pettine has turned into favorable field position early in this game for the Cleveland Browns at the start of their drives.
They start from the 42. This is Terrence West. And West is across midfield, has a first down to the New Orleans 44-yard line. West gains 14.
Terrence West does really a nice job of going and setting up those defensive linemen with a little stutter step in the backfield, Darrell.
Well, he does it continually through the run, Tony. It's, as you pointed out, great watch. Set him right there, out here. Now set him there. So just that little hesitation allows the lineman to get on his block.
This is West. Again, he stumbles. Browns go to the hurry-up, which was so successful for them in the second half last week against Pittsburgh.
Brian Hoyer with his first tackle.
Yeah, that's a nice tackle by him.
He didn't learn that from Tom Brady.
That's the old trick in third grade, walking down the hall when you kick the foot behind the buddy in front of you.
Second down and 12. Hoyer looking left, and now he throws. Incomplete. It's headed for Gabriel. Corey White on the coverage, third and 12 upcoming.
I know this field, when you look at it from home, it looks like AstroTurf, but this is real grass out here. Just a great job, beautiful field. Probably the nicest field we've seen in the last couple of years, Darrell.
Yeah, it does look like an artificial surface when you look at it from television, but natural grass, as you pointed out, Tony, it's one of the best I've seen in the NFL.
Absolutely.
Hoyer on third down and 12. Pass is caught by the tight end, Barnage. And the former Carolina Panther picks up the Browns' first down. Gary Barnage gains 13. Remember, no Jordan Cameron today, the Pro Bowl tight end. So Barnage stepping up, picks up the first.
And a nice job by Brian Hoyer, buying a little bit of time to allow this route to develop, because they drop Gary Barnage in coverage. And he just able to buy that extra tick to float it out there in the flat.
Hoyer starts the game 5 for 9. Big completion on third down. From the Saints 32. Play action. Hoyer fires to the outside. Intended for Benjamin.
There, I'm really impressed with Cleveland, you know, and I gotta let everybody know, this is the one place that you never did a game, so you've done every NFL stadium so far and every team, right?
Yeah, Cleveland was the last stadium to check off the list, and have had a great weekend here in the city. Really enjoyed
fans.
My time here.
Great,
yeah,
fans.
They always have. They've had tremendous fans.
Second and 10, it's Crowell. Isaiah Crowell to the Saints 25, forced out by David Hawthorne, gain of 6, so it will be 3rd down and 4 for the Browns.
And we have to really pay off the wide receivers for the Browns, too, because, you know, you get to talk about them in the passing game as receivers, but they do a really nice job in the run game. And if you're going to have this style of offense where you lean heavy on the run, you're going to have participation for your guys on the outside, and they do a heck of a job blocking downfield.
Barnage shifting, 3rd down and 4, and Hoyer's pass deflects off the hands of Miles Austin, who scored the Browns' touchdown earlier.
Everything but the catch. The route is run well, gets the separation, working back to the ball, and right through the hands.
So Austin unable to make the catch. Another ex-Dallas Cowboy out onto the field. It's Billy Cundiff, former Saint as well. It'll be a 44-yard attempt from the left hash. Cundiff 2 for 2 last week against Pittsburgh. penalty flag prior to the kick.
This could be big if it's on the Saints, and it looks like it is. Sean Payton's, whether it's a squeeze by the center, whether it's something to get his players on the line to move.
Zone infraction.
That's a crippling penalty right there.
And the biggest thing is because obviously this is no good. You know, it's the Saints are going to dodge one here. Hits the upright, comes back.
To the Browns.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Kenny.
It was Patrick Robinson. Remember, he was called for that big pass interference earlier in this quarter. Robinson, the guilty Saint, off the fake to West. Warriors pass is short. He was looking for Andrew Hawkins in the end zone. So Patrick Robinson, the GOAT, on a couple of occasions in this first quarter.
Yeah, and Sean Payton's going to get with him right away. You have to understand, when a team lines up for a field goal in a fourth and four situation, it's one of the first things that goes out is don't be offside. Don't be offside. It's in any situation where it allows the offense to come back on the field. And Patrick Robinson with a big mental mistake there.
The two huge penalties committed by Robinson. This is West. West inside the 20 to the 19-yard line.
A lot of zone blocking up there, Darrell, and one thing you're not going to see from a zone blocking team that you normally would from the Cleveland Browns, none of those guys on the ground cutting. You know, when you see the old Denver Broncos going to run in the zone, always on the backside you would get the cut, but not these guys. They're athletic enough to stay up, and they still go and get it done.
10th play of the drive for the Browns. Burned out at 8. Boyer spins, and now he throws. And stopped about 3 yards shy of a first down as the tight end, Jim Gray, by Kenny Vaccaro, the second-year safety. So the Browns will send out the field goal unit once again.
Yeah, an important tackle right here, fighting his way through there, getting him down, because Jim Gray's got a clear path. It's a nice job by Kenny Vaccaro, working his way underneath some players and getting that tackle made.
This will be a 32-yard attempt for Cundiff from the right hash. Spencer Lanning places it down, and this time Cundiff's kick is straight through. So the Browns give it a reprieve on the penalty. Now lead the Saints by the score of 10-0. So one quarter in the books here in Cleveland. Terrific start for the Cleveland Browns in their home opener. Give the Cleveland Browns defense a lot of credit. The numbers on the left, certainly not what we have come to expect from a Saints team.
Now, we talked about it at the top, keeping things in perspective. The Saints offense played very well last week against Atlanta. And boy, hats off, as you said, Kenny, to the Cleveland Browns defense. Heck of a job so far. And a lot of that, the pressure that Drew Brees has been under here at the start of the game. And it's four down a lot of times. You know, we're not having to bring that fifth and sixth guy and expose ourselves in coverage against this skill set that New Orleans has. The Browns have been able to do this rushing four.
That one for one first down in the first quarter really sticks out.
And the Saints also forced to burn two timeouts in the first quarter with the play clock winding down, and Brees blew for only 9 yards. Saints with one first down. So we start the second quarter. And this is Pierre Thomas. Thomas takes it out to the 29-yard line for a gain of 9.
One of the luxuries that the New Orleans Saints have on this roster is their running back position. Mark Ingram, Kyrie Robinson, Pierre Thomas, Travaris Cadet. Four guys, and you'll see three of them the majority of the time. Mark Ingram, you know, he's kind of your go-to guy. Pierre Thomas, thought of as a pass receiver, but I always used to think of him as a power runner, but he's really evolved. And Kyrie Robinson, very physical when he's carrying the football.
On second and one, this is Robinson. Robinson picks up the Saints first down. Down to the 35. Well, Pierre Thomas was the Saints' leading rusher a year ago. Ingram, of course, the former Heisman Trophy winner, and Robinson in his second season out of West Texas A&M.
And all three of those guys over 4 yards per carry, and that's pretty impressive. And it was a point of emphasis for the Saints in the offseason to improve that running game, to get to it more during the course of the game and strike more of a balance.
Out to the 40-yard line, it's Thomas.
Trouble getting everybody separated down there, Goose.
Yeah, they're just talking about good old times. Like you used to do, Darryl.
That's what happens when you start running the ball. Things get a little heated.
A little upset.
Chuck it down in five. Saints back to the backfield. Can't find anyone. Now he throws. Robert Meacham, the intended receiver. Now the rookie out of Oklahoma State, first round pick Justin Gilbert, who had a tough time last week in his NFL debut. Gilbert on the cover.
Yeah, nice play on the ball there, but that's Drew Brees' second read in the progression. He wants to go here to Travaris Cadet, but they are doing such a good job early in the coverage that when New Orleans wants to throw the ball quickly and Drew Brees sets his feet and looks, the guys are covered. That's coming all the way back to the other side late in his progression.
Third down and five. Empty backfield once again for the Saints. Brees sets and throws. And the Saints will be stopped short. It's the tight end, Benjamin Watson, the ex-Patriot and Brown. Watson out to the 39. And the Saints, after picking up one first down on this drive, will punt it away.
Jimmy Graham, no catches yet.
Nice job through one quarter, but Mike Pettine knows he's got a long way to go before he feels comfortable with Jimmy Graham not catching a ball yet this afternoon. That's a 60-minute guy you got to defend.
Nobody back deep yet for the Browns. Now the punt by Morstead. Browns did not get a return man out onto the field. There was some confusion on their sidelines. Well, for the Saints offense, four possessions, four punts. Back in Cleveland with the Browns leading the Saints 10-0.
Still trying to find some answers there on the sideline, Tony.
Yeah, he's been in there. He ran right, as soon as he got to the sideline, he went right to the bench, grabbed the tablet, and just staring at it. Just staring at it, trying to figure out exactly what this defense of the Cleveland Browns is doing to him.
On first down, Hoyer hands it off to West. And Terrence West gains four out to the 15-yard line. Well, these teams do not face each other very often, but the coaching staff's very familiar with one another.
Yeah, and a lot of it comes from, you know, Kyle Shanahan, his time at Washington, and Rob Ryan, his time in Dallas. So very, very familiar with the styles right there. And just in the preparation to hear Drew Brees say, we played the Jets and the Bills last year, so we went back and looked at that defense that Mike Pettine was a part of at those times. So something that we thought coming up here, maybe there's some unknown and some unfamiliarity with these two teams. They were dialed in, both of them, in their preparation during the course of the week.
And Mike Pettine spent many years with Rob's twin brother Rex Ryan, both with the Ravens, and then he was defensive coordinator under Rex Ryan with the New York Jets.
And even to the point with Brian Hoyer coming in, and sometimes you wonder how that's going to apply to an offense that was run. We were able to find some Redskin film that Rob Ryan was trying to defend Rex Grossman as opposed to Robert Griffin III, so a really good idea of what he would do against Brian Hoyer.
Third down and two. Hoyer's pass is complete for a first down to Andrew Hawkins.
One of the things that Kyle Shanahan talked about Brian Hoyer is courage in the pocket, and it's something you can't teach. It's something you have to have. You got to be able to stay in there and take the hits when you know they're coming.
Again, the Browns in the hurry up. Cleveland offense quickly up to the line of scrimmage. First and 10 from the 25-yard line off the fake to Crowell. Hoyer fires downfield, and it is broken up. Patrick Robinson makes the play. Pass intended for Travis Benjamin.
Yeah, big play action right here with a chance to try and get up over the top. You heard the audible at the line of scrimmage, so something in the front. It makes Brian Hoyer think that he can get Travis Benjamin over the top. Patrick Robinson stride for stride, and the timing. I've gotten away with a little push right there at the end. We're calling things a little bit tighter this season.
On second and 10 off the fake to Crowell. Pass is caught by Hawkins. And Hawkins takes it out to the 31 before he's dragged down. All right, Vaccaro, how about Andrew Hawkins, a guy who spent some time in the Canadian Football League? He was on Michael Irvin's reality show, fourth and long, finished second in the competition, grad assistant at his alma mater, Toledo, and then he was hired as a scout by the Lions. He thought his career was over, went to work in Detroit. They offered him a full-time position. He said, I want to give it one more shot.
Good for him. Good for him. You never give up on that dream. If the opportunity presents itself, go after it as hard as you can. It's a testament to his fortitude to stay with it.
And now on third down and four, it is Crowell. And Crowell is stopped about 2 yards shy of a first. Curtis Lofton along with Jarris Bird. So the Browns will punt it away.
Isaiah Crowell didn't know what to do. He got out in the open field. He wanted to find somebody to run into, Tony.
Yeah, no one out there.
What do I do? It's open space.
Don't ever turn around and come back to the play. You just draw more guys there.
Hooks back deep for the Saints. Spencer Lanning waiting at his own 20. Is called for by Cooks at the 17-yard line. Second quarter in Cleveland. Browns leading by 10. Cletus enjoying the action here in Cleveland today.
Well, that's one of the cities that we don't get the opportunity to get to very often, so Cletus is coming in to check out what Cleveland's all about.
Fans are loving him here down on the field. Screaming his name. He's got a rough ride over here, a little tanged up.
I think he's been wrestling out in the parking lot, tailgate.
Doing something. It's a new paint job.
Take care of that for us, Goose. Saints strike a call from the 18-yard line. The Wallers with only two first downs so far today as Breeze lobs one up for Pierre Thomas. And Thomas pulls it in at the 29-yard line for a Saints first down.
Nice touch by Drew Breeze on this throw right here. You finally get a little bit of pressure. You're going to bring five. You run Pierre Thomas out of the backfield, loop him there. Just dropped right in over the top by Drew Breeze.
Gain of 11 for Thomas. Now Ingram in the backfield. Jimmy Graham still without a catch today. First and 10 from the 29. This is Ingram. And Ingram picks up a first down and more. Finally steps out of bounds. And for the first time, the Saints have crossed midfield.
You lose contain on the edge. Mark Ingram never has to change his stride. We talk about Jimmy Graham as a pass catcher. We look at him as a blocker. Excellent job of climbing up to the next level to block Chris Kirksey. If your guy knifes inside, then climb up to the next level. Don't stand around and not be somebody who was involved in the play.
Gain of 26 for Ingram. The Pro Bowl corner, Joe Hayden, is the injured Brown.
Sponsored by AT&T. Mobilizing your world.
There is Joe Hayden, the injured Brown. Off on the sidelines. First and 10 for the Saints. Justin Gilbert over at left corner, replacing Hayden. From the 49, the 5-yard line. Quick hole. First down and more for Brandon Cooks. Cooks takes it inside the 20 to the 17. Another Saints first down.
This is excellent ball handling. Watch Brandon Cooks coming in from the right. Hits it in stride on the cadence. That was the best part of this play, is the timing of the cadence in the motion, where he never had to slow down to execute that play and hit it full speed.
Well, safety markers prior to the snap.
On the field, on the defense in formation. It's a 5-yard penalty, still first down.
They didn't even try to get off the field there. They just figured, ah, let's try and play with 12. Maybe they won't realize it.
A Rams defense that has played very well until this point. They've given up some big plays on this drive.
Well, it's hard, and they're going to make their plays. The Saints offense is going to make their plays. The key right now is to hold them to a field goal in this situation.
On first down, pump fakes, now pulls it in and dives to the Cleveland 9.
So you've come into this game, and I love the confidence of Mike Pettine of deferring and putting the offense on the field. It gives his confidence, or his defense, a boost of confidence. They've played well up until this point, but you have to understand, when you play the New Orleans Saints, eventually they're going to start to get into that rhythm. It took them a little bit longer today. It's been the running game on this drive that's really kind of opened up this offense this afternoon here today.
Second down and 2. From the Browns 9. And coming up to make the tackle is Tashawn Gibson. So the Saints now facing a third down and 2.
That's a great job by Gibson dropping down in there. That was a big running lane, and he's your eighth guy. He's your safety. That's dropping down into the run game.
Yeah, if he doesn't make that tackle, it's a touchdown. The hole is gigantic.
Breeze on third down. Pass is caught, but not enough. Josh Hill, the tight end, makes the catch. Carlos Dansby brings him down. It is now fourth and about a yard and a half.
That's a good tackle by Carlos Dansby, because this is a short yardage to go and is to convert. Drew Brees again has to hold it a little bit till he gets that clear lane. And look at the tackle. There's really no yards, not even an opportunity to run after the catch with that for Josh Hill.
Browns convert earlier on fourth down on their touchdown drive. It is now fourth and 2. For the Saints. And Brees is forced to use his third and final timeout of this first half.
The third and final timeout. This is a 30-second timeout.
What that means is over the next 3 minutes, 20 seconds, Sean Payton cannot throw his challenge flag.
Yeah, 5 minutes, 20 seconds to the end of the half. And get him after this promo. Read the card, Kenny, and then we'll follow up on your thought there.
Well, Darryl, brand new show coming to Fox. The critics are raving about, saying things like, it's a lightning bolt of fresh air with the hit ensemble of the season. You don't want to miss Red Band Society this Wednesday at 9, 8 Central on Fox.
And I really question the need to call that timeout right there. You know, at this stage, you know, it's going to add you 5 yards. You know, take the delay of game penalty and keep that timeout in your pocket.
He just didn't like what the front was doing. The front was shifting over. They had a trade to the tight end to the other side. Everybody was moving.
That might have been calculated, Goose. They're just trying to get him jumping.
So this will be a 27-yard attempt. Shane Graham from the left hash. And Graham's kick is good. So the Saints are on the board. Saints using their final timeout, and then they don't run the play on fourth down. Send out the field goal unit. Browns by 7. Back in Cleveland, Kenny Albert, Darryl Johnston, Tony Siragusa. Just over 5 minutes remaining. Second quarter. Browns leading the Saints 10-3. New Orleans held to only 5 first downs, 16 passing yards so far today.
Unbelievable. After you watch them on film last week, that the offense for the Saints played well in that opener against Atlanta, and you expected that to carry over here this afternoon, but credit Cleveland's defense. They've played well here in the first half.
Marlon Moore suspended last week. Back deep. Browns will start from the 20, leading by 7.
Well, it's been all Browns in the first half. Just haven't been able to get in sync offensively for the Saints. Bad snaps, sacks, under pressure, just four guys rushing majority of the time. On the other side of the ball, Cleveland Browns being very efficient with their offense. Miles Austin with a three-yard touchdown catch.
Saints punted on their first four possessions. And 23 passing yards for Drew Brees. Hoyer just able to get rid of it. Off the pressure from Corey White.
There's that toughness that Kyle Shanahan talked about. Coming off the edge, untouched here. You've got the hard play action, but I mean, there's not even a hesitation by Corey White. He's going towards the quarterback. He's not chasing down that handoff. Nice, clean, physical hit right there on Brian Hoyer.
Second and 10. This is West. Stays on his feet. Tries to bounce it to the outside. Nowhere to go. It'll be third down and 9 for Cleveland.
Brian Hoyer still looks like he's a little banged up there. Watching him from behind.
Well, we'll see. See what they do here with the play call. If they hand off again here, give you an indication he's not quite back to it yet.
Hoyer looked to throw on third and 9, and that pass gets batted down. It's Cameron Jordan, the Saints Pro Bowl defensive end, and now the Browns forced to punt.
Get in, get upfield, get into those throwing lanes. There's number 94. Little chip, tackle slides out. Just slide into that throwing lane, make that deflection. Your offense had momentum on the last drive. Good job by the defense coming out, forcing a stop. See if the Saints can do here on the punt return, get some good field position established.
First time the Browns have gone three and out today. Brandon Cooks from the 34. Cooks looking for a lane. Well, Cooks loses a couple on the return. Time for another game break to Los Angeles. Joel Klatt.
All right, Kenny, let's go out to New Jersey. Eli Manning trying to get the first win of the season. Connects with Reuben Randall for a 7-yard TD catch. And the Giants pull within 3. It's 10-7 right before the half. Back to Cleveland. Kenny, Moose, and Goose.
All right, thanks, Joel. Both teams coming off Monday night games. Hoyer looking to shake it off after taking that hit from Corey White.
Yeah, that he still hasn't gotten that one out of his system yet. And you're completely exposed on that time. You're booting out, you're trying to elevate to make that throw, and you expose everything. Take that shot right in the ribcage.
Best starting field position today for Drew Brees and the Saints. From the 32-yard line, the handoff to Mark Ingram. And Ingram is out across the 40 to the 45, shoved out of bounds by Gilbert. Ingram picks up 12 and a Saints first down.
Second time on consecutive drives where the Saints running game has gotten to the edge, losing contain. The Browns defense losing contain on the outside.
Joe Hayden has returned for the Browns on defense. Injured on the last Saints drive. Saints empty the backfield, first and 10 from the 44. Green steps up and fires, and it is picked off. The interception by Gibson. He's inside the 20, the 10, takes it all the way for a Cleveland touchdown to Sean Gibson.
Browns continuing to do a great job defending Jimmy Graham. Drew Brees looking to go to him in this situation right here. It's going to sail on him a little bit. Here he comes, number 80 right here, coming off the line. gets beyond the linebacker depth, moves into the middle of the field, and you can see it sails a little bit. And it sailed a little bit because Paul Kruger, number 99, was bearing down on Drew Brees.
Second career touchdown for Gibson, who took it 62 yards. High snap. Lanning had trouble with it. Boy, it's been a tough couple of weeks for Lanning.
That's a tough cutback right there, I'll tell you that.
Kicked to the face mask by Antonio Brown last Sunday, and now forced to try and reach the end zone and took a hard hit.
You know, you talked about the ball floating on Drew Brees. Darrell's taking a quick look right now. You talked about Paul Kruger. Watch him right here. He comes up the field, makes an inside move right here, and he is right in Drew Brees' face as he throws the ball. Hit the nail right on the head, Darrell. Combination right there. Good pass rush and good coverage, keeping your eyes back on the quarterback.
Guys, the last time Drew Brees faced the Cleveland Browns was back in 2010. Rob Ryan was Cleveland's defensive coordinator, and the Browns intercepted Brees four times, and they returned two for touchdowns.
Well, that's one of the things we talked about with the familiarity. You know, Drew Brees talked to us about, you know, we played the Jets and the Bills last year, similar defenses. You know, Mike Pettine's the defensive coordinator of the Bills last year. During training camp, I go against Rob Ryan's defense, which is a part of that whole tree. So he's very, very familiar with this, but it's not the scheme today. It's the execution of the scheme today by Cleveland's defense. They're doing a great job. The number one thing, Tony, and you talk about this all the time, if you can get pressure on the quarterback with just four and drop seven into coverage, it's a huge advantage.
Absolutely. Now your linebackers, everybody don't have to worry about bringing in that extra fifth guy. You get another guy in coverage. They've been doing a great job of putting the heat.
Taken out by Cadet. Down at the 14-yard line.
You know what? They struggled a little bit last week in special teams against the Pittsburgh Steelers as well. They have been outstanding in coverage up until this point.
So with 3:21 remaining, second quarter, a 16-3 lead for the Browns coming up. On the Visa Halftime Report, Kurt, Terry, Howie, Michael, and Jimmy, first half analysis. And as Joel Klatt told us and showed us earlier, RG3 parted off the field. Kirk Cousins comes in, and the Redskins lead the Jaguars 21-0. First and 10 for the Saints from the 15-yard line. Brees to Jimmy Graham, and that is his first reception today, and he drags three Browns with him out to the 38, 23-yard pickup.
And it's the pressure that this offense puts on you. They are so explosive. You can never relax. You've played really, really well the entire first half up until this point, but if you relax for a second, they will make you pay for it.
Longest pass play today. Prior to that play, the longest completion for Brees was 11 yards. On the 38, out to the 43-yard line, it is Pierre Thomas. Remember, the Saints do not have any timeouts remaining. As the clock continues to run, down to 2:20. Saints burned all three of their timeouts, two in the first quarter, and one on a fourth down play. And then following the timeout, they kicked a field goal. On second and six, play action. Brees to the outside, and the catch is made by Kenny Stills, who missed last week's game with a quad injury, 14 yards, his first reception today. We've hit the two-minute warning in Cleveland, where the Browns lead the Saints by 13. This game on Fox is sponsored by iTunes. Follow your favorite team all season long. Go to iTunes.com/NFL. Browns lead the Saints 16-3. Penalty markers, false start, New Orleans.
false start. Offense, number 64. 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
Right tackle, Zach Streif.
I just got that you did your math in your head earlier, Mr. Porter Kenny, when I corrected you on the 520. You said 320. I see the 2 minutes now. I got it. I got it. I was a little bit late to the party, but I'm there now.
You can't correct that.
This is Graham, his second catch. Buster Screen made the tackle. And what Darryl's referring to is you cannot challenge following the two-minute warning. Everything comes from upstairs. So when the Saints use their final timeout at 5:20.
Kenny did the math in his head. He always does.
Second down and 8. Pass is caught by Thomas. Thomas to the 38.
Both of these teams struggled in tackling in week one, and we've seen it on both sides from both of these defenses. Players to the ball. If you break one tackle, there's other guys coming in pursuit to get you. So one of the things that both of these teams have corrected here in the first half is their pursuit to the ball.
And remember, New Orleans burned all three of their timeouts early in this first half. They have none.
Breeze on 3rd and 3, complete to Graham. So the Saints pick up a first down, and Drew Breeze leapfrogs over John Elway. He's now in 4th place all time in yardage. They set it down. It's for the Saints. Again, it is Graham.
You just can never relax against this offense, and especially against Jimmy Graham. And you just, it's 60 minutes, and you got to defend him every snap.
His 4th reception of this drive. Breeze to the outside, looking for Graham again, this time incomplete. Over 51,500 yards. Surpassing the great John Elway.
I wonder if they had any idea that that was going to happen when they came here together for the first time, Sean Payton and Drew Brees, that down the road he'd be over 51,000 yards.
Second and 10. Breeze fires, end zone. Incomplete. He was looking for Meacham.
Looked like it was right there for Robert Meacham. That back shoulder throw. Exactly, Tony. Coming off the top of the screen, number 17. Joe Hayden's bailing on it. You got Dante Whitner underneath. You put it in the perfect spot.
Drew Brees is not happy after he saw that drop right there.
Third down and 10. 24 seconds remaining in the half. Brees over the middle. It's Meacham. Remember, the Saints are out of timeouts. Meacham picks up the first down, under 10 seconds, and now Breeze stops the clock with 8 seconds remaining.
Yeah, I think they'll take a shot into the end zone. One of the times that a lot of coaches will look at is 6 seconds as being kind of on that fringe of whether you can take one more shot into the end zone if you're close enough. So the Saints keeping their offense out there with 8 seconds left here.
Jimmy Graham's back in. He was out the last couple plays. They got him in right now. If I was on this defense, that would be one guy that I would be taking a look at and make sure he's covered.
Eight seconds on the clock. Second and goal. Time for one shot to the end zone. Receivers to the right. And now a timeout is taken by the Browns.
Cleveland. This is their first charge timeout.
Let's take a look at what's coming up on the Visa Halftime Report with Kurt Menefee. Kurt.
Coming up on the Visa Halftime, RG3 carted off against the Jags. We'll have an update. Adrian Peterson's backup gets on the board against the Patriots, and the Dolphins and Bills battle for the top spot in the AFC East. We got all that and more coming up on the Visa Halftime.
All right, thanks, Kurt. Drew Brees over to chat with Sean Payton. If the Saints trailing by 13. Jimmy Graham split to the right. Breeze to the end zone. It is Graham who comes down with the football for a Saints touchdown.
That's a tough spot to put Joe Hayden in right there. He's one-on-one with Jimmy Graham. You've got the height advantage. It is, you need to get some safety help over the top. Make him beat you somewhere else. That's just, it's making it too easy for Drew Brees and Jimmy Graham in that situation.
Too big of a body. I mean, he's going to go up. That's a guy you want to go and stop on the line of scrimmage. Don't let him get started. And he's too big of a body to go and just cover him one-on-one.
Five catches for Graham on that drive, 57 yards. This is Shane Graham who adds the extra point. A 12-play, 85-yard drive for the Saints who reached the end zone for the first time today.
Yeah, and I just think you walk somebody out. You just show that you're going to have two guys here. You look at that's a true one-on-one. It doesn't matter if you're going to buzz out your linebacker, Chris Kirksey, you're going to run him out underneath. That's too late. The ball's up in the air. Bring a guy and put him right on top of where Joe Hayden is. Just say, hey, what? You know what? We're putting two guys on Jimmy Graham in this situation. You're going to have to go find somebody else, Drew Brees.
Cleveland fans won't want to hear this, but it was Bernie Kosar who worked with Jimmy Graham down in Miami. He played 4 years of college basketball, had 1 year of eligibility remaining. He was talked into playing on the football team at Miami, and he worked with the former Browns quarterback, Bernie Kosar, on routes and coverages and really learning how to become a football player.
You're going to throw one of Cleveland's favorite sons under the bus, Kenny? What are you going to say about Brian Sipe next? Brian Sipe helped out Robert Meacham? Holy smokes, Kenny.
Come on, Kenny, get him. Kenny, don't just sit there. Get him.
Sorry, guys. Drew Brees spent time working out with Brian Sipe. Anytime we can get Bernie Kosar into the broadcast, it's a good thing, Kenny.
Former teammate of yours in Dallas?
Absolutely. Awesome.
Kick taken at the 35-yard line. All right, Jim Leonard. As this first half comes to an end in Cleveland.
Well, we've talked about how good Cleveland's defense has played here. The New Orleans Saints are one play away from taking a 17-16 lead.
Browns will get the ball first in the second half to the studio in Los Angeles following this break. Start as a Brown, the local product, 9 of 19, 67 yards, and a touchdown in the first half.
I think that that tells you that it was a very defensive-oriented first half. But as the guy said, you know, from Brian Hoyer, you know, nothing sexy, but he's not doing anything wrong. He doesn't have the turnover. He's been efficient, showed some courage in the pocket. But the fear about when they play the Saints is it's got to be a 60-minute game. You know, we're down to 16-10 right now. They're one play away from taking the lead after a very good first half of defense.
Marlon Moore on the return for the Browns. There is a flag. Two penalty markers thrown as Moore takes it out to the 25. Went on referee Craig Wolstad.
Holding, receiving team, number 30. 10-yard penalty. First down.
That's on Jim Leonard. So you think back to the start of this game, and Mike Pettine deferred, so he gave the ball to the Saints. Browns defense started the game on the field, forced a three and out. Now it's the Browns offense to start the second half.
Yeah, the second opportunity in making that choice at the beginning of the game. His defense held up their end of the bargain in the first half by providing great field position the entire half. Now it's up to the offense to finish that here to start the second half. Put together a good drive, start to establish, even if you don't get points, change the field position. But that penalty on the kickoff return, not a good way to start.
Forces the Browns back 10 yards. From the 15-yard line, the toss to Terrence West. And kicks it out to the 23 for a gain of 8.
That's a good run by Terrence West there to start this game. Press, press, press to hold, and one cut and go, and that's how the blocking goes in the style of running game that Kyle Shanahan has put in place here.
This is West again. He's close. Browns pick up a first down, Goose.
Had a chance to talk to Mike Benton, and, you know, talked about the first half. He was very pleased. Like Bruce said, he went and deferred. The defense came out with a great tempo. One thing he wants to do here in the second half is make sure that they have the same tempo they did in the first half. I wish you could have that playback with Jimmy Graham. He said, listen, we got our best player on their best player. They just came down with it, but we're up by 6. We've got to play some good defense, and we have to go and stay on top of it. Throw things at them that they haven't seen before. Keep them on their toes.
Here's Johnny Manziel on the field for the first time as a Brown. Second and 10 from the 25-yard line as Manziel hands it off to Isaiah Crowell, who gains a couple.
Yeah, there's a lot of discussion in New Orleans about how they're going to handle this, because there were rumors about the package with Johnny Manziel at quarterback, and they felt confident in what they'd be able to show on tape of Rob Ryan's defense against RG3 when the Dallas Cowboys played the Washington Redskins. So you can teach off the film there. Doesn't sound like they spent a whole lot, because you might just get that one play, and you don't want to lose practice reps.
So Brian Hoyer back in. Third down and 8. Flag as the pass is caught by a wide open Andrew Hawkins, but it's a hold.
Offense, number 73, 10-yard penalty, replay, third down.
That's the 7-time Pro Bowler, the left tackle, Joe Thomas.
Now you only have 3 penalties in the entire first half, and you've got 2 here in the second half already. This is canceling out a big play that kind of gets you out of your own end of the field.
Against the 23-yard completion, backs the Browns up to the 18-yard line. Hoyer on third down and 18. Is incomplete. He was looking for Travis Benjamin. So the Browns will punt it away early in this third quarter.
Well, this is their own fault. They start the second half with a penalty on kickoff return that backs them up. They get a pass down the field to get out of their own end and maybe start to build some momentum, and they get another penalty. So not a great start here the second half by the Cleveland Browns, and everything within their control.
Spencer Lanning waiting back at his 3. Brandon Cooks back deep for the Saints. Fair catch called for at the 43 by Cooks. Johnny Manziel makes his NFL debut early third quarter here in Cleveland.
On Fox is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. Without a heart, it's just a machine. By Papa John's, official pizza sponsor of the NFL. By all the Old Spice products, which you should use all over your body. And by the Lincoln Motor Company and the first ever MKC.
Browns lead the Saints 16-10 on a sunny 60-degree afternoon. Yesterday, a bit overcast, cool, but nice day today.
Yeah, it was funny, Sean Payton, when we talked to him, you know, looking at the schedule at the start of the season, identifying warm and cold weather games, and they had this one circled as a potentially warm weather game, and we assured him that that would not be the case today. It's going to be perfect weather for football.
Saints start from the 43-yard line. Ingram in the backfield. And Breeze hands it off to Mark Ingram. Up the middle, Carlos Dansby makes the tackle, a gain of 6.
It's just such a long day at the office for a defense when you play against the Saints, because you can play well, look at that, for the first 6 drives, and then look what happened there right before halftime. And they get the matchup they're looking for down in the red zone with Jimmy Graham against Joe Hayden. Best against best, but that's still tough duty for Joe Hayden. and it just puts so much pressure on a defense.
Brees' pass intended for Graham. Hayden on the coverage. Time for a game break. Joel Klatt, Joel.
All right, Kenny, so Detroit has all these offensive weapons, right? Megatron, Reggie Bush, Brandon Pettigrew, Eric Ebron. Who do they go to from the one? Jed Collins with the touchdown. 7-6 Lions over Carolina. Back to Cleveland, Kenny, Moose, and Goose.
Kenny, I don't know if you're keeping track today, but I think that's the third fullback touchdown we've seen this Sunday.
At least three. They're making a comeback. They're making a comeback, the fullback position.
It's not extinct. It's not extinct. We've had sightings.
I see one here in the booth. Third down and four. Brees with time. Now over the middle, complete to Graham for a first down for the Browns 35.
You cannot defend chemistry and trust between a quarterback and a receiver downfield. And there's Justin Gilbert down on the play. But the Browns defend this well. Time in the pocket. You know, we've talked about them being able to hurry Drew Brees. Not on this play. That gives Jimmy Graham time to ad lib. And just that feel that's hard to defend when you know each other so well.
Sixth reception for Graham. Browns medical staff tending to the rookie corner, Gilbert. Justin Gilbert to the sidelines, the Browns' first pick in the draft, eighth overall.
Yeah, good to see him walking out. I see him coming over the top there, so right onto the face. So don't want to speculate what it was, but awkward landing for Justin Gilbert.
First and 10 for the Saints from the 36 off the fake to Ingram. Brees finds Ingram out of the backfield. Ingram stays in bounds inside the 30 and finally knocked down after picking up a first down for the Browns 24. Some nice creativity and Ingram gains 12.
Yeah, little ad lib right there, just staying alive for your quarterback, flick it to the outside. And I thought they had some guys rallying from the inside right here, but Mark Ingram makes them all miss.
Gets the thumbs up from his quarterback. Here's set of downs for the Saints. From the 23. The give to Ingram. Cuts it back inside. Ingram inside the 15. The 10. And wrestled down by Hayden at the 8. So Ingram gains 15 more.
Talk about a cutback, Darrell. He cut back all the way.
Yeah, and this is the third time we've seen the Browns lose outside contained. So keep your eye right here as the cutback happens. Jimmy Graham washes that all the way down. Jabal Sheard not there, and you actually kind of make a collision with Joe Hayden. So that's the third time the Browns have lost contained for a big run.
Now down to the 6-yard line. It is Ingram. Well, the Saints go to Ingram on three consecutive plays, and now Pierre Thomas checks in. Brees only 9 yards passing in the first quarter. He's picked up the pace. 67 yards on the ground for Ingram. And Graham did not have a catch until that late drive in the second quarter when he had five.
Now, that's the whole issue with Jimmy Graham. He shut him down almost the entire first half. And you saw those stats there right now.
Graham, top of the screen. Split wide to the right. Play clock winding down. Brees throws. And stopped just shy. Is Kenny Stills. Dante Whitner coming home, Cleveland native, former Bill and 49er, playing in his first home game as a Brown. Whitner makes the tackle.
Wow, that ball looked like it hit the pylon to me. I'm standing right here.
Yeah,
unless he stepped out right beforehand.
Yeah, it looked like he did, Goose.
Okay.
So now the Saints facing third and goal from the Cleveland one. And a timeout is taken by the Saints.
Go back look. Yeah, take a look at Tony.
His right foot right here, they said.
Yep.
Yep, just stands right there on the white.
Good call. So the Saints, who used the timeout early in the first quarter, call timeout prior to this third and goal from the one.
I mean, you can justify this one. The ones early in the game were just the mechanics of getting the play into the huddle and getting to the line of scrimmage in time. This one, this is a big third down from this spot on the field. And all we've talked about with how well Cleveland has done, they get a touchdown here with the extra point. They've got the lead by 1 point. The explosiveness of this offense is something you have to guard against the entire game.
Ingram in the backfield, two tight ends. Graham in motion. Third and goal from the one. Reeves to the end zone. It is Graham. And it's rolled a touchdown. He crossed the plane. Second of the day for Jimmy Graham.
Well, we saw him go in motion. He's going to leave that wing on the left side and cross formation. Buster screen running with him, so you've got man there. A little bit too far off him at that point. Makes it easy for Jimmy Graham just to push up that field a little bit, break to the flat for the touchdown catch.
So Jimmy Graham with touchdown receptions on the last two Saints possessions. Here is Shane Graham. Saints have their first lead of the day. A one-point differential. The botched snap and hold on a Browns extra point attempt.
Game on Fox is sponsored by Microsoft Surface, the official tablet of the NFL.
One-point lead for the Saints here in Cleveland. Jimmy Graham with a pair of touchdown receptions, so the Saints have battled back from a 16-3 deficit in the second quarter. They now lead by one. An eight-play, 57-yard drive as Breeze checks it out on the tablet. Marlon Moore is back deep for the Browns. First and 10 from the 20 for Brian Hoyer and the Browns. We check in with Mike Pereira in Los Angeles. Mike, communication between the officials this year, they're wearing the headsets, also able to interact with Dean Blandino in New York on reviews. How do you think it's going so far?
You know, I think it's going great. How about just week one? Think about this. Last year in week one, there were 38 replay stoppages in week one last year, only 21 in week one this year, only four so far today. And we're midway through the third quarter, so I love the result of this. Less reviews.
Big hole for Isaiah Crowell. And Mike, on that last Saints touchdown, quick call by the officials. The correct call is Jimmy Graham crossed the plane.
Yeah, and a correct call by the coach, too. You know, they're getting the video, and they decide not to challenge. And I think that's shown a trend, too. Coaches are challenging less when they get a shot that shows that it's really questionable. So I think that area's improved also.
And, Mike, we had the reaction from fans around the country the first couple of weeks of the preseason with the point of emphasis of illegal contact, defensive holding and stuff. And we're going to have to break from you. You got Johnny Manziel. He'll be right back with you, Mike.
Mike wants to watch this as well. Mike, of course, keeping a close eye on college football as well for Fox the last few years. So the second play for Manziel, and he hands it off, and Crowell is swallowed up by Curtis Lofton, and Manziel will stay on the field. So for the first time, it is back-to-back plays for Johnny Football. He's handed off twice. Second down at 13. Manziel looking to throw for the first time in his NFL career. And the pass is incomplete. It's the fullback, Darryl Ray Agnew, the intended receiver.
Well, it wouldn't be a Johnny Manziel pass unless we had to ad-lib a little bit. A little fake hack, fake on the play action right there, looking downfield, and here it comes. I'm spinning and I'm going to my left. And he's got Ray Agnew. Look at that. He opens wide open for him out there in the flat, and it's thrown well and just can't hold on to it.
So Manziel 0 for 1. We thank Mike Pereira, and we'll check back with Mike if needed later in this game. Hoyer on 3rd and 13 steps up and fires, and the catch is made. Close to a first down, it's Gary Barnidge.
I really think that this is something the Browns are going to have to figure out a way to make work during the course of the season, because the quarterback is the one position that, in my opinion, you want consistency. And, you know, we've seen teams create a package for a running back, for a wide receiver, for a tight end. Kyle Shanahan's going to have to juggle that. Now, he's worked in a similar situation with Kirk Cousins and Robert Griffin III in Washington, two very different style quarterbacks with different things that they bring to the table. But he always went with Robert Griffin III and Kirk as the backup, being the higher draft pick. And it'll be interesting to see how he works through this, because this is one of the things I think you can find yourself overthinking, and that's bringing in a quarterback into a specialized situation and disrupting the rhythm of the offense. They haven't been a great rhythm today, so maybe that was just something to say, hey, let's see if we can create a spark with Johnny Manziel.
Barnage did pick up the first down. First and 10 from the 40. This is West, and Mike Pettine, the Browns head coach. Ball came loose at the end of that run. Looks like West was a little down, but Mike Pettine was in New York with the Jets when Tim Tebow and Mark Sanchez would rotate on occasion.
Yeah, so they've got a little history of being in a similar situation, but this one is obviously going to be a little bit more. I mean, Johnny Manziel is a dynamic football player. He's got his following, and you know, I think that being a number one pick in your first round draft pick, that's
looks like the Browns
be clamoring for him to be on the field.
12 men in the huddle, Cleveland
against the offense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
So this will force the Browns back 5 yards. When we talked to Brian Hoyer on Friday, he said Johnny and I get along better than most people would guess. He said on draft day it was a sense of relief when the Browns chose Manziel, because I knew who I was going to be competing with. I was focusing on my rehab at the time, but I was aware of what the task would be and who my competition would be. Hoyer on second and 12, and the pass is caught by Miles Austin out of the 47.
Well, they'll evaluate after today's game. I don't know if we'll see it again. I stand by my decision or my opinion early on. You know, I think to disrupt the quarterback position is something that you have to take very, very seriously. I don't agree with it.
I'm with you on that, Kyle, too. That's just hitting that right on the head.
Down at four, and the Browns pick up the first. Miles Austin into Saints territory, and for Brian Hoyer, he has made his way back. Thank you. Back to September of 13, made his first start for the Browns, then suffered the torn ACL the next month. Browns draft Johnny Manziel in May. Hoyer, the local product, named the starter in August. Here's Crowell. Hoyer grew up here in Cleveland. In fact, he was at the Browns' last game at the old stadium back in 95 before they moved away. And some of his favorite players as a youngster, Bernie Kosar, Eric Metcalf, Kevin Mack, Eric Turner, Webster Slaughter. Some of the great Browns of the late 80s, early 90s.
Yeah. That's why it's such a great story. You know, grows up here locally, a fan of the team, and ends up coming here in a quarterback battle, winning the position.
Second down and three. It is Crowell who finds a hole, picks up a first down and more for the Saints. 23-yard line. 17-yard pickup for Crowell.
And we talked about being able to run this path and just kind of stretching and pressing and pressing, and then when you have your cut, you're gone. And that's what Isaiah Crowell does so well. He's running on a track, and they'll call it a track or a path. You run that, you get that in sync with your lineman. When you see your opening, you put your foot in the ground and you go north-south.
The 11th play of the drive for the Browns. This is West. Terrence West gains 3, down to the Saints 20.
And the good thing about it, what they discovered last week, is they have two players that are good at doing this. Terrence West, a little bit maybe big play potential, but now you've got fresh backs that are rotating in and out.
Second down and 6 off the fake to West. Hoyer throws, And the catch is made, taken all the way down to the 10-yard line by Andrew Hawkins.
And this is why it's so important for the run game to be effective for the Cleveland Browns, because now you get that defense running, having to respect that press cut run back. And now all of a sudden here comes Brian Hoyer out on the edge on a bootleg, and you've got receivers down the field.
First and goal from just inside the 10. A give to West. And he's bottled up by the combination of Junior Gallant and Cameron Jordan. Second and goal upcoming. This will be the 14th play of this drive for the Browns. Johnny Manziel was in for two of the previous 13. Cleveland started from their own 20.
Yeah, and a great response after you lose the lead to New Orleans.
Three receivers set. West in the backfield. This is West. Inside the five to the end zone. Touchdown!
On this replay, I want you to watch the offensive line and the running back and watch how they're in sync. As Terrence West goes, see if they're on the same track together. As he's breaking at an angle, the offensive line is breaking on almost that exact same angle. There's the cutback lane. It gets expanded. You've got the backside cutoff by John Greco, number 77, that creates the running lane for Terrence West to put his foot down and go north-south.
And Alex Max also, the center, does a nice job of getting to the second level.
The extra point. First NFL touchdown for West. He scored 41 at Towson last year. Yes, 41 touchdowns. Terrence West and Isaiah Crowell celebrate on the sidelines. Brian Hoyer and the Browns go 14 plays, 80 yards.
Always make sure you go thank your big guys up front after a scoring drive.
And get him something for Christmas also. Right, Darryl?
Yeah.
Got some time, Goose. And Tate suffered the knee injury last week, the former Houston Texan. So West and Crowell did a terrific job against the Steelers and continue here today against the Saints.
Well, when Jim Brown compliments your running style, that's high praise, and both Terrence West and Isaiah Crowell got complimented by Jim Brown after last week.
Browns lead the Saints by six. Terrence West, Cleveland touchdown. 14 plays, 80 yards. They kept the ball for over 6 minutes. Three tight end set for the Saints. Robinson in the backfield. This is Robinson up the middle for a gain of three.
It's been interesting this afternoon for the Saints offense. It's been the running game that's kind of got this offense to jump start. I mean, we're used to seeing the explosive plays down the field and the challenges on a defense to all the different playmakers across the secondary. But today, it's really been Mark Ingram and Kyrie Robinson and Pierre Thomas that have jump-started it with the run game.
Yeah, and it slowed down that pass rush also because those defensive linemen were worried about that run.
Second down and seven. Catch is made by Stills. A yard shy of a first down, so it will be third down and one.
In the offseason, trying to strike some balance with the run-pass ratio for the New Orleans Saints. And success with the yards per carry in the rush.
On third and one, spinning across the 30 is Robinson, and it looks like he picks up the first down out to the 31.
Good tough running by Kyrie Robinson there to convert the first down. A little bit better job on run support by the Browns defense getting up and securing that edge. Joe Hayden coming up a little bit late, but there's Desmond Bryant falling off to help out.
Third to Gilbert. Back in for the Browns. Checked out for a possible concussion earlier. Gilbert back on the field. This is Cooks. Cooks to the 34. Time for a game break. Los Angeles, Kurt Menefee.
And this is one of those that takes a little bit of time, although the way C.J. Spiller is going, it's not going to take that much. 102-yard kickoff return for a score. Buffalo on top of Miami, 16-10. Time winding down in the third. Kenny Moose and Deuce.
Thanks, Kurt. Big win on the road for the Bills last week in Chicago.
Yeah, I think it surprised a lot of people with the performance in Chicago.
Second down and seven. Under a minute to play, third quarter. Breeze to Graham for a Saints first down. Out to the 48.
The Saints like to cycle through formation or personnel groups, and one of the things you're looking for is who are you going to match with us? And this is one that they'll come back to, because that's a tough job for Carlos Dansby to cover Jimmy Graham man-to-man. He's going to have some help somewhere, but underneath, it's all his responsibility.
Nothing in the first quarter. 8-6, including two scores. Ingram cuts it back inside. Mark Ingram to midfield for a gain of two, and that should do it for the third quarter here in Cleveland, where the Browns have gone back on top after falling behind by one. Both teams suffered heartbreaking defeats last week. Who will it be today? Browns by six. Each team with a touchdown in the third quarter. Jimmy Graham, Terrence West. Browns leading Sean Payton Saints by six. Home opener for Mike Pettine and the Cleveland Browns. Second down and eight. Ingram in the backfield. From midfield. Breeze with time. He throws. There is a flag as the catch is made by Meacham at the Cleveland 38.
Hands to the face. Defense, number 71. That penalty is declined. The result of the play is a first down.
One of the points of emphasis this year, you're not allowed to get that hand on and then get it right back off if it goes on. This was being used as a tactic by players, so in regards to player safety, they changed that rule. So anytime it stays on there, it can't be brought off right away. And boy, Ataba Rubin not only got it there, but he left it there and used it to his advantage. Easy call for the ref.
On first and 10 from the 38, this is Thomas. Here Thomas picks up seven. Gibson the tackle.
It's tough. I mean, they've got, you know, the receivers on the outside, but I think that their running back rotation is very much underrated. When you look around the league, to roll out Mark Ingram, Kyrie Robinson, Pierre Thomas, and Travaris Cadet, he's kind of your home run guy that kind of gets lost in that shuffle there. That's a good set of four running backs to go with.
Ingram in the game, second and three. This is Ingram. Ingram finds a hole and picks up the Saints first down for the Browns' 23-yard line.
They're not really specialized. There's certain areas that I'm sure Sean Payton would prefer to have one or the other, but they do everything well, and you can see that. And one of the things that he really monitors, Coach Payton, is the number of touches he's getting to his running backs. We talked to him about the play calling and during the course of the game, and he's like, yeah, one of the things I really keep an eye on are my touches by my running backs.
Robinson in the backfield. 10th play of the drive. Off the fake to Robinson. Breeze hit as he throws. And the pass incomplete. Craig Robertson with the contact on Breeze.
This is a nice job by Drew Breeze avoiding the sack and the lost yardage that comes around. It looks like he's got no chance to get that ball out, and he's got somebody in the area, so it's not going to be intentional grounding.
Breeze had completed his previous seven attempts. Now second and 10. left side. And it's Graham who makes the catch. Jimmy Graham down to the Browns 3-yard line following the anticipation by Darrell, who circled him on your screen.
Well, you're going to get one-on-one, so you're going to have to look out that way. And Joe Hayden does a great job. I mean, look at the coverage, but the body position that Jimmy Graham is able to create is something that's so difficult to defend. He fights his way. He gets into the prime location of being in front of the defender. I mean, Joe Hayden really can't play that ball much better that time.
Can't do anything else than what he did right there.
First and goal, it's Ingram. Mark Ingram down to the one.
That's got to be frustrating as a defender, Darrell. When you're in the perfect spot, you're doing everything right, and just the size of the body of the receiver just gets in the way, and you can't get your arms around to go and punch the ball out. And just, there's nothing else that he could do, Hayden.
Second and goal, Ingram. Ingram is in for a Saints touchdown.
Nice mix on that drive by Sean Payton with the pass and the run. You get down to this point and just let the offensive line come off the ball. Let Mark Ingram get in behind your fullback, Austin Johnson, and find his way into the end zone.
And this is what their offense runs, the Cleveland Browns. So they see this every day with the zone blocking up front. They've just been, in this, last couple of minutes of this game, they've just been manhandling.
Graham adds the extra point. The Saints have scored touchdowns on their last three possessions. Graham twice, and now Ingram lead by one.
Today's Game on Fox is sponsored by Domino's. Oh, yes, we did. By DirecTV. If you call yourself a sports fan, you gotta get DirecTV. And by Bud Light, who reminds fans to stay in the game and drink responsibly.
It's a one-point game in Cleveland. The difference following this interception return for a touchdown by Gibson. It was 16-3 at this point, but then the failed execution on the extra point attempt.
One of those plays that we take for granted. We just automatically think, to the point where the league kind of experimented this year. We're pushing the extra point back because it had become almost automatic. And it just goes to show you, once you take something for granted, something can happen. It's the difference in our game right now.
That's a good point. And of course, if Lanning had reached the end zone, it would have been a two-point play.
He'd be the hero right now.
Marlon Moore back deep for the Browns, who had a 16-3 lead, now trail by one. And will start from their own 20. Early fourth quarter here in Cleveland. Kenny Albert, Darrell Johnston, Tony Siragusa. In case you missed it, Browns used Johnny Manziel on three plays earlier. He handed off twice and attempted one pass,
which should have been caught, but was dropped by Ray Agnew. So he's ready to go again on the sideline.
Buckled up too, got the chin strap on and everything.
Always ready. It's Hoyer out of the shotgun. Crowell, the long back. Hoyer on first down, complete to Benjamin. Down to the 26 for a gain of six, forced out by Patrick Robinson.
Both of these offenses in the second half really kind of starting to hit their rhythm, just trading scoring drives back and forth.
Back-to-back 80-yard scoring drives.
And that is not easy, not in today's NFL, to be efficient for that long and not make mistakes to put you behind the count on the down and distance is difficult.
Browns went 14 plays, 80 yards, and then the Saints followed up by going 14 plays, 80 yards. This is Crowell. Isaiah Crowell to the 29, setting up a third down and one. Saints now at 345 total yards. After they get off to a slow start, Saints punted on their first four possessions, but have scored touchdowns on their last three. Third down and one. first, out to the 34.
This turned into just a smash-mouth football game, Carol.
Yeah, but I like that little motion that they add to this play. As your wide receiver comes around the back, it's going to grab the attention of the defense, and you've got eyes on. You have to respect that kind of end-around type speed sweep, and then all of a sudden you slip the running back up into the front.
Cleveland Browns have lost their last eight games, last seven last season, and the opener in Pittsburgh as Hawkins takes it out for another Browns first down, and we check in with Kurt Menefee. Kurt?
All right, Ted Ginn Jr. is a wide receiver, but he's one of the better return men in the league. Proving it now with the Arizona Cardinals against the Giants, bouncing off tackles, 71 yards for the score. Arizona up 22-14 in the fourth. Kenny Moose and Goose.
All right, thanks, Kurt. Ted Ginn Jr., who grew up here in the Cleveland area, good friends with Dante Whitner of the Browns. Ted Ginn Sr. was their high school coach, and Whitner credits Ted Sr. for much of the success that he has had thanks to football.
Yeah, I love to hear the stories of somebody who had an impact made on them by a coach in their really younger playing days.
Like the center, Alex Mack, had a bit of an issue with his shoe. Second down and eight. Players pass sails over the head of Miles Austin.
They're bringing the blitz right up the middle, right on Hoyer. Take a look at it. Eight guys in the line of scrimmage. Somebody's going to come free. Two guys did. Tell you what, he bounces right back up. Really impressed me after that last hit he had earlier in the game.
He hangs in there.
Yeah, he does.
Curtis Lofton's right in his face.
Third down and eight. Is made by the tight end Barnage, but not enough. Corey White wrapping up Gary Barnage. Browns not only missing their starting running back Ben Tate, but their star tight end Jordan Cameron. And now they will leave the offense on the field, fourth down and three.
This is what the New Orleans Saints offense does to their opposition. You mentioned it, Kenny. They've scored on their last three drives.
Well, now change their mind. Offense initially stayed out on the field, but now Mike Pettine sent out the punting unit. Play clock winding down. Browns just got the snap off. Fair catch called for at the 10 by Bird. So the Saints with the football and a one-point lead. Fourth quarter here in Cleveland. This October, history will be made as baseball's postseason moves to America's new sports network. Fox Sports 1 is your new home for baseball's National League Division and Championship Series, and it all begins this October. One-point lead for the Saints. New Orleans has scored touchdowns on their last three possessions, three long drives.
And I think that that's one of the reasons now Mike Pettine decides not to go for it on that fourth down. But you start to think about that. It's a little bit early here in the fourth quarter. There's lots of time left. But this offense will do that to you. You'll worry about having another opportunity to get down the field and score when you get out near midfield. So good execution, though. And this is weighing that whole balance. You know, if you don't succeed, you give the Saints great field position. Here's playing the conservative route. They executed it well by downing the punt right at the 10-yard line.
Just under 9 minutes remaining, fourth quarter. Both teams went right down to the wire last week, both losing by three. And the pass from Breeze is caught for a first down out at the 23-yard line by Cooks.
I couldn't believe Drew Breeze got that ball off. Wow, did he have pressure right in his face. I was standing 10 yards behind him, and that was an amazing throw. I know it doesn't seem like much, but you're down here on the field. Very impressive.
Yellow, yellow, yellow!
From the 23 on first down, it's Ingram. And Ingram works his way up to the 26-yard line.
just seems down here on the field, just a little bit of a lull on the Cleveland Browns defensive side. A lot of energy early in the game, even coming out of half. But now it's sort of like they're lining up. They're not really, you know, nothing really creative on the line of scrimmage. They're lining up in the same spot every time. And New Orleans is just picking them off.
One of those situations in a game, Tony, where somebody has to make a play. You saw the graphic with the three consecutive touchdown drives. It's a response to the concern they have.
Lost the electricity down here.
Second down and 7. Brady steps up and throws, and the catch is made out at the 37-yard line. For a first down, it's Jimmy Graham, who ties his career high with his 10th reception of the game.
That just shows you how difficult it is to match up with Jimmy Graham. I mean, absolutely no production in the first quarter, and now he's got tied his career high. And whether it's zone, whether it's man-to-man, he's got the great body position. He's got the great feel, that basketball background of, you know, knowing, you know, when to find open space, how to position your body at the point of the catch. Tough to match up.
For Graham with 10 catches, none for Marcus Colston today. He's on the sidelines. Breeze on first down, and that pass batted down by Paul Kruger.
And we really haven't heard from Paul Kruger since the beginning of the game either. You know, we're waiting for somebody to step up and make a play. He's coming from a two-point stance there on the left side at the bottom. You're not going to get there, but elevate and get that ball knocked down. Somebody has to make that big play. They had a couple big plays early on in the game when they were having some success defensively.
Now two tight ends. Ingram in the backfield. Graham in motion. From the 37, off the fake. Breeze under pressure once again, and he throws it away.
Well, you wanted a little bit of pressure from Paul Kruger, Darrell. You got it on that one. He made a spin to the inside, just kept coming. They had two guys covering him. Watch him right here. Comes upfield, sees that he's going to get a little bit of a spin back inside, comes back outside. Puts enough pressure for Drew Breeze to just throw it away.
That's probably about the fourth time that we've seen Drew Breeze do that, and that's big. That's, you know, he's probably saved this offense about 30 yards, 40 yards in sacks by just getting rid of that ball.
Colston back out on the field, third down and 10. Breeze over the middle. It's Robert Meacham for a Saints first down in Browns territory, a 15-yard connection.
Yeah, I just don't know how you cover everybody. Coming off the bottom of the screen, working against Joe Hayden again on that in route. The separation in and out of the break by Robert Meacham is where he gains his separation. Joe Hayden stride for stride until he makes that break inside, and that's where he separates.
So a new set of downs for the Saints as we approach 6 minutes remaining. New Orleans with a one-point lead. A handoff to Robinson. And Kyrie Robinson takes it to the 44 for a gain of 4.
We talked about Jimmy Graham not having a lot of production in that first quarter. If he's not having a great day, that means Drew Brees is off to a slow start as well. A very low total for him at the end of that first quarter, but he's really caught fire here now since that time.
He threw for 9 yards in the first quarter today. Start of the game, 7 of 13. 19 of 25, 6.
Hey!
Down and 6. This is the fullback, Johnson. Another Saints first down, Austin Johnson.
They just keep attacking that middle of the field on the Cleveland Browns defense. That's got to be the strong point in your game. If you want to have a good, consistent defense, you got to stop everything coming up the middle and force them to go to the outside.
Now 172 yards on the ground, Goose, for the Saints today. On the 36. Eight of 2 for Robinson, under 5 minutes on the clock.
I think that this is huge for this offense as well. You're going to get into types of games like this. Like Tony said, it's kind of that slugfest style where it's very physical with the run game, and it's a game that we really haven't seen Sean Payton and his group perform well, you know, through the history. We all know about what they can do throwing the football down the field, but this has been impressive this afternoon, watching this run game really be the group that kind of kick-starts the drives.
eating up the clock once again. 10th play of the drive for the Saints. They've scored touchdowns on their last three possessions. Breeze to the near side. It's Cooks. Gilbert makes the tackle at the Browns 31.
They just seem to be able to find people to fit back into a spot when they lose somebody. They lose Lance Moore. They go out, they draft Brandon Cooks, he comes in, and you can see already two games into his career that he's going to be a special player in this system. He fits it very, very well.
Huge play coming up, third down and five with the clock under 4 minutes. Saints must get to the 26 for a first down. Padet in the backfield.
First unconventional lineup right here from the defense that I've seen.
On the toss, it's Cadet, but the Saints called a timeout prior to the snap.
Timeout, New Orleans.
Second timeout taken by the Saints with 3:36 remaining. If the Browns can stop New Orleans here on third down, and Saints would have to settle for a field goal attempt to keep it a one-score game.
Second timeout this half, Kenny, but that's the third timeout this afternoon that New Orleans has had to use because the play clock was winding down. So I know that Sean Payton can't be happy with the communication in and out to get set at the line of scrimmage.
Of course, if the Saints score a touchdown, they're trying to pick the extra point. Still a one-score game, but you would need a two-point conversion. Saints punted on their first four possessions. Touchdowns on their last three drives, and that botched connection on the extra point attempt is the difference. Third down and five. Breeze in trouble. Down he goes. Carlos Dansby with the sack back at the 39-yard line.
And that may have taken them out of field goal range, Kenny, and Drew Breeze immediately went to Pierre Thomas. So something went on there. Carlos Dansby is going to come right here from the center.
That's right up the middle. I mean, the guard has got to identify that linebacker coming in the center. Bad communication.
I think you're absolutely right. Went to Pierre Thomas, though, Tony, I think it's the running back's responsibility. It's shotgun. He has the ability to cross formation and pick that up, and he released, and that was the first guy Drew Breeze went to after the sack.
So a huge sack. Would have been a 56-yard attempt, so the Saints punt. The kick takes a Saints bounce, stays out of the end zone. But the Browns keep the Saints off the scoreboard. A huge sack by Dansby. Breeze talking about it with Thomas.
To buy Lowe's. Lowe's never stop improving.
1 point lead for the Saints. Since returning in 1999, the Browns have gone just 1-14 in their home opener. Their only win came over the Ravens back in 2004. Their last win of any kind also came over the Ravens last November. Hoyer on first down fires downfield, and the pass is behind the intended receiver, Andrew Hawkins.
Got a little bit of pressure coming to your face. I don't know if that's an adjustment by the receiver, because he had two defenders running stride for stride with him, and it looked like Brian Hoyer might have expected him to shut that route down and run more of a deep comeback than to continue going down the field. I like the aggressive play call, but what are you going to do on second and 10 here backed up? That's the risky run when you're aggressive in your own end.
From the 4-yard line, Austin in motion. Hand off to West. There is a flag. That's on Kenny Vaccaro.
I tell you, the Saints figured out something there, because all their defenders walked up right exactly where the Browns were trying to run that football. So they had something early in the game.
Same thing you saw, Darryl.
Yeah.
Out to the 13-yard line, it is West.
obviously Sean Payton and Rob Ryan not on the same page here at the end of the game.
Third down and one. Parted shifting. Boyer from the shotgun. Quick release. And the catch is made for a first down by Austin as we hit the two-minute warning here in Cleveland. Well, new set of downs for the Browns following this chat on the sideline.
Not something you want to see as the game's winding down and it's only one possession.
2 minutes remaining in Cleveland. Browns with all three of their timeouts. They trail by one. First and 10 from their own 17-yard line. Empty backfield. West flies up in the slot. Boyer on first down throws, and it's incomplete in the vicinity of Miles Austin. Second and 10 coming up.
Yeah, Brian Hoyer expecting him to come a little bit further, get into that window, and Miles Austin shut it down a little bit short. He's got to clear that blast underneath defender and settle into that soft spot. That could have been disastrous.
Three receivers, all split to the right. Second down, it's Gabriel. Taylor Gabriel out to the 24, gain of 7.
Second time we've seen that motion used in this offense to grab the defense's attention and then right back to where it came from on a little quick screen.
Third down and 3. Boyer throws, and the catch is made, and Austin nearly broke free.
Well, you heard the groan from the crowd. If Miles Austin breaks that tackle, there was not another Saint defender within 18, 20 yards.
Another big reception on third down by Austin. And now it is Gabriel again. Gabriel after the 34 with 1:08 remaining. The Browns use their first timeout. Cleveland on the move, trailing by 1. Saints lead by 1. It was the Browns by 6 at the half. Third quarter, Jimmy Graham with a second touchdown reception of the game. Put the Saints on top, and then Terrence West, 9-yard touchdown run. Browns by 6. And the culmination of a 13-play, 80-yard drive, it's Mark Ingram into the end zone. And that is where we stand, a 1-point differential. Browns with that botched extra point attempt earlier back in the second quarter. There's Billy Cundiff. Will he have an opportunity? Second and 10 from the 34. Boyer being chased. Down he goes. Back at the 32-yard line, it's Junior Gallette.
It's one of the things that we've been waiting to see from this New Orleans Saints front. It's only one sack, one hurry last week against Atlanta, that first one today.
Third down and 12. Gabriel to the 37. And now the Browns use their second timeout. 38 seconds remaining. As the Browns now face fourth down, down by 1.
Yeah, but we've kind of sensed this the entire time we've been here this weekend, Kenny. This is not your same old Browns, and Mike Pettine wanted to get that across to us, that we're not rebuilding, we're building. And, you know, it may not make sense to you, but when you're around this team, you start to understand what he's saying. They're not scrapping everything. They had good players here. You've got several Pro Bowlers that are on this roster, and he felt that he just needed to kind of change the belief in the players. And he's kind of coming through more from that direction, and I think that's where you're starting to see that. Their second-half performance last week, their performance here the entire afternoon.
But they must convert here. Fourth down and 7. Browns must get to the 44-yard line. Boyer throws, and it is Barnage who makes the catch for a Cleveland first down. Browns have one timeout remaining, down to 23 seconds as they try to get it to field goal range for Cundiff. Warrior throws to the 37-yard line. And it's ruled to completion to Austin. That is the initial ruling. See if the officials put some time back on the clock. It is ruled a completion at the 39-yard line. What do you think?
Everything that we have with the catch, yeah, I agree, Tony. You know, he's got possession of the ball. He's established himself in bounds and secured it through the process of the catch.
The ruling on the field is a catch, and the player went out of bounds.
So now with 8 seconds remaining, they have not adjusted the clock as of yet. That is what
the previous play is under review.
The Browns would like a clock adjustment. Line of scrimmage, the 39-yard line. And now that last play is under review. One-point game, late fourth quarter. The last play is under review. We'll bring in Mike Pereira. Mike, what do you think?
Well, I tell you, they ruled it a catch, and I think it is a catch. Don't think he went out of bounds first. He's going to come back in, I think, the shin and probably the rearmost part of the body, that favorite body part of mine, hits first.
The ruling
in
on the
bounds.
Field stands.
So I think it stays.
Ruling on the field stands.
In 8 seconds.
Says Greg Lundstedt. Clock at 8 seconds. Browns have one timeout. So, Mike, you think they got it right?
Yes, they did, and if they didn't reverse it, they can't make any adjustment with the clock, so they handled this correctly.
Administrator, please put 15 seconds on the clock.
Whoa, let me see this.
For Mike, they added 7 seconds. So now 15 seconds remaining. To 10 from the 39, and that pass gets batted back. Now to 13 seconds. So, Mike, they did add time onto the clock following the review.
Because of the fact that the official ruled him out of bounds initially, so they corrected that on the field.
Right.
It appears that the clock kept running.
So now 13 seconds. Thanks, Mike. Second and 10. Browns have one timeout. Warrior locks one up. There is a flag as the catch is made by Hawkins. Hawkins was wide open, but a penalty marker was thrown prior to the catch.
Looked like it could be a hold on the defense. The middle of the field.
What a horrible time for the Saints defense to blow an assignment right there. Andrew Hawkins wide open beyond everybody. He's going to come out of the point of the slot, the tip of the slot. They drop him all the way. Completely dropped in coverage by the Saints coming out of that bunch look.
And Patrick Robertson right in the middle of the defense there went and hooked him, and that's what they call the hold on.
So here's Billy Cundiff. The Browns trailing by one, 6 seconds remaining. Browns had a botched execution on the snap and hold on an extra point attempt earlier. Ball will be placed out at the 19, so this will be a 29-yard attempt. Cundiff has never missed from under 30 yards. He's 63 of 63. To give the Browns the lead from the right hash, the kick is good. Mike Patton, rookie head coach. His team has taken a two-point lead with 3 seconds remaining. A drive, Darrell, that started on the Cleveland 4-yard line.
I cannot tell you how impressive this is. The maturity of Brian Hoyer in that situation, never panicking. Great job by Kyle Shanahan with the play calling. And a testament to this group. You showed the graphic before they started that drive. They've only won one home opener here since they returned in 1999. In that situation, the expectations that they're going to take the ball down the field and have a field goal opportunity to win the game is a testament to that gentleman right there, because he really is starting to change the way this team believes in itself. We recognized it when we were here this weekend, when we sat down and talked to him, and that is the greatest example that they could show to us, to the people here in the stadium, and everybody watching on TV. This is not the Cleveland Browns that you're used to seeing over the last 14 years.
Mike Patton, a high school head coach as recently as 2001. There's Sean Payton. He has not started 0-2 in a season since 2007.
And let the talk begin about how difficult it is to get into the playoffs at 0-2. This New Orleans Saints team is good enough to overcome that. They've struggled in their first two games, getting beat by a divisional opponent in a shootout and hitting a team that has a lot of emotion on their side here in this home opener for them.
The clock has hit zero. And the tackle is made. Ball comes loose. No flags. The ball game is over. Brian Hoyer, the Cleveland native, now 4-1 as the starting quarterback for his hometown Browns. Mike Patton wins his first game as Browns head coach.